very well worth about, well, quite a bit of money spent on TV, daylight, outdoor light. Mock-up's almost hot. No, oh, you're talking about the first scene, yeah?
Yeah.
That's, I don't know, it's TV lighting inside. The camera platform picture. The speech side picture is pretty cool too.
Yeah, but you don't have a mock up there.
Like, oh, yeah, sure. It's unbelievable. You'll see. I think the speech side is better.
You can make better.
Bigger commitment to the space program in terms of money for the future than you have.
I'm trying to do all that's possible to get some problems. This program is the highest
priority.
Of the globe in a couple of hours? It can be done. Can we do it? It can be done. Can America have the space station Freedom orbiting the Earth in 10 years' time? Yes. All these things must do it. Because in the next century, leadership on Earth will come to the nation that shows the greatest leadership in space. About all the joyous endeavors. It is High Flight by John G. McGee Jr., an American pilot who flew with the Royal Canadian Air Force in World War II. In the tumbling mirth of sun-split clouds and done 100 things you have not dreamed of. Wheeled and soared and swung, high in the sunlit silence. Hovering there, I've chased the shouting wind along and flung my eager craft through footless halls of air. Up, up the long, delirious. I thank you. God bless you all. And God bless America.
Mr. President.
Find its way to space, but I'll bet you it winds up in a presidential library.
Which isn't surprising, because when you're my age, everything reminds you of something else. Seems there was a great old man, a wildcatter, a rancher, a political leader, one of those people who's done it all in life. Well, a greeting like the one you've just given me really does make me humble. Stands for the very things that have made America a light unto the nations. The bedrock principles of family and freedom, peace and prosperity, a strong community, and a strong America. Now, you'll hear the liberals talk about these things too. You'll hear them say there are no disagreements between them and us about these bedrock principles. But it doesn't sound right. They use our words and borrow our tunes, but the song is way out of key. That tax sure was a windfall. A windfall for liberals and their government programs, that is. But in 1980, thanks to people...
Strength and unselfish giving, it gives me great honor to represent all Texans in presenting this replica of the flag of the Republic of Texas. This lone star should serve as a reminder of our love and support from your friends in the Lone Star State.
And then you can say you don't know.
Check.
Come on back. Still be glad to tell you.